Hello, and welcome to a demonstration of MediaPulse. In the next few minutes, we will go over some of the major changes to the schedule book from version 8 to version 9. Right away, you should notice a few differences. For example, the Zoom level is now located at the bottom right, next to the layout tools. Also, the Y-axis has changed in look and functionality. Let's look more closely at the Zoom level. Hover your mouse over the different levels. You will see a pop-up text indicating the amount of time displayed at the Zoom level. Use this to help you adjust the view of your calendar. If we look at the Y-axis, you can now see it matches the colors of the weekdays, and the weekends are a different color. If you want to change the look, go to the Actions menu and select Display. Then click on Choose Colors button. This is where you can customize the colors of the backgrounds, view items, separations, and bars. You may need to update the text colors in your schedule book with this new update. Once you have the desired colors, click Apply and Close and save the display. To save this view, go to the Actions menu and select Save View. Along with a new look, the Y-axis has some new functionality. For example, to expand or collapse a group of resources, click on the arrow or the area to the right of the group name. If you click on the group name, a pop-up window will appear with the bar details. Now you can easily adjust the height of any row. Simply hover your mouse over the group or resource on the Y-axis until you see a double-headed arrow. Click and drag up or down to adjust to the desired size. If you want to adjust the size of an entire group, click and hold Control while you click and drag to the desired size. You can also select one or more resources at a time by clicking on either side of the resource description. When you select a resource, it'll become highlighted. Use Shift and Control keys to select more than one resource. For example, I am clicking on Shift to select a few resources. Now I'm using the Control key to select more or unselect. Once you have the resources you want, you can view the calendars associated with the resources with Calendar View. You can see the calendar changes if you unselect a resource. You can also add a work order or quick hold to the selected resources. Simply click and drag on the calendar for the desired date and time. You can easily add a resource to an existing booking. Click and highlight the booking, then go to the Y-axis and click on the desired resource. This will add the resource to this work order. Notice all the other bars not associated with the same work order are now dim. Use the right mouse button to delete the booking. You can also click and shift-click a range of bars for a resource. This will allow quick moving of bars for the resource. There is an imaginary line on bars from the lower left corner to the upper right. You will notice the cursor change depending on which side you're on. The cursor drag arrow icon is for moving the bookings, and the finger icon is for selecting. The schedule book has a few new hotkeys, which are shortcuts within MediaPulse. For a list of these hotkeys, go to the Actions menu and select Mouse Keyboard Help. A pop-up window will appear with some helpful information as well as a list of hotkeys. As you can see, the letter T will bring you to today's date on the schedule book. You can change the display forward or backward by entering a number followed by D, W, or M, standing for day, week, or month. Lowercase letters will bring you forward, and uppercase letters will bring you backward. For example, 3 lowercase d will move you forward 3 days. 5 capital W will move you back 5 weeks. Please note, the focus must be on the schedule book for the hotkeys to work. Another change to the schedule book is the Add View button. This button is located next to the Actions menu, and it can create a new scheduling view. When you click on this button, a new tab will appear with a timeline and without groups or resources. Go to the Actions menu and select Items. Then pick which groups you want displayed in the new view. Click Save. You can duplicate any schedule book view by clicking on the duplicate icon in the Actions menu. To split a tab, simply drag and drop the tab into the shaded area, either to the left, right, or bottom. In the Actions menu, select Timeline and check the box next to Keep Tabs, Dates, and Times in Sync. This will keep your views in sync. For example, let's move forward 5 days. To save this configuration as a dashboard, go to Settings, Dashboard, Save Dashboard, and name your new dashboard. These are just a few of the major updates to the MediaPulse Schedule Book. For more helpful videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you have any questions, please contact us at support@xytechsystems.com.